Today I would like to show a move called a kind of a classic time-size movement called Tug of War. And a lot of times what I see with my students or with practitioners that they do it in a way that can be improved. And I first show a way that, I mean, it's not bad, but it can be much better. Like a lot of people, what they do, they place the foot here and the heel is away kind of from the hip. Then they take the leg over it, pull back, lean backwards, and pull on the leg while they're pressing the foot. Now what happens, maybe you can see my toes start to collapse, and my toes become very pointy. And when somebody's heavy, it gets a lot on my foot, a lot on my leg. So there's a much better way of doing this. Better for the practitioner, but also better for the client. First, we're gonna hold the foot like this, so the knee cannot fall outwards. The right foot comes flat against the hip. And first, we just let the leg fall. So basically, the attachment of the hamstrings falling onto my foot, and just let it fall. That's the first step. Second step, the hand comes behind the foot again. I press the knee to the opposite shoulder. And what happens? The hips start to move. The hips start to move up, up, up. I don't move the foot, I only move the hip, and I place the foot again. If the heel goes away back, press the heel forward again, so it's under the toes. And then this is the second step. I'm almost there where I like to be. Again, there's no pulling yet, just falling down the leg. Then one more time. I press the knee towards opposite shoulder, the hip comes up. I press, slide my foot further under, and then one hand under the ankle, one hand under the leg. I pull, most pulling, not from here, but from my right hand. And the moment I pull, I can push the toes away. Now you can see this is much better for my ankle, much better for my toes. And for the client, it's not sharp and it feels soft, and you can really get a nice stretch here. Now from there,